Hello everyone, myself Nupur Joshi. I'm part of Fusion HCM Analytics product management team. Today I'm going to talk about payroll or salary expenditure of an organization and various peripheral aspects impacting payroll expenditure in an organization. Also, how Fusion Analytics Warehouse payroll offering helps organization in identifying all such leading indicators and take required decisions ahead of time and stop organization from bleeding money. As per various analysts and articles published, payroll cost contributes to 70% of OPEX of an organization. There are mainly two user personas being talked about. The CEOs, the CHRO, that is the C-suite folks, and the other executives. That is the key decision makers in an organization. Especially in cases when the profitability shows downward trends and the OPEX seems to be eating up profit margins of an organization, then this set of decision makers may look for answers of some of the business questions like, why is there a steep increase in overtime paid to X business unit or any other component over a period of time? Is there a correlation in excess overtime being paid and burnout and attrition? If there is continuous increase in attrition in an organization, that means you will also end up hiring more people continuously. When you are hiring people from outside the organization, then you might end up paying them substantially high amount as per the market trends. Then you would also want to know, are we paying substantially high amount to the new incumbents as compared to the existing workforce? And then another business question, another question arises from this is, this might lead to dissatisfaction amongst the existing workforce, and then they might eventually quit the organization, leading to increase in the attrition of an organization. Are these all leading indicators to me that I should review or revise my workforce salary, workforce cost, as well as revise my retention policies? To answer all these business questions, then comes another user persona in picture. They are the analysts and the payroll processing users mainly. What they would do to answer the business questions raised by the decision makers in an organization. What is the current month expenditure versus past month salary expenditure or across any pay period, current year or past year and likewise quarter as well? How much amount have we already paid under overtime or bonus in current quarter or any other time dimension? Which workers have we paid more bonus or overtime over a last 1 year or could be any time dimension as well? With help of these business questions, they'll be able to provide enough input, enough data to the decision makers to take the right decision for the organizations. Also, for the second set of users that we are talking, for their regular job as well, they need a lot of data. For example, to provide the cash departments to provision sufficient fund to process salary for a specific month. Also, they would need data like how much amount was paid in last pay period and provide some percent increase on top of that or approximate that much amount to be provisioned for this month of salary as well. So such type of data is always required by the regular payroll users as well. So now with this, we have identified two main asks. That is the aggregate payroll reporting and retrospective reconciliation. How have we solved that in Fusion Analytics Warehouse payroll offering? For aggregate reporting, we have 80 plus measures available in the subject area. We have close to 40 plus measures for only period to date reporting. That covers your month-to-date reporting, quarter-to-date reporting, year-to-date reporting. That can answer the business question that we just talked about, like how much overtime have I paid in current quarter or in current year or could be any time dimension. The second set of aggregate measures that we are supporting in the subject area are on variance and anomalies or variance and growth rates. So you can identify how much is the variance between 2 year, two quarter or two pay periods or any two time dimensions. And what is the growth rate? How much has it increased or decreased? So that can help you identify if there is a steep increase or steep decrease in any specific component. The second key feature is the retrospective reconciliation. So the main ask is the reports that were generated at the time of payroll processing should remain sacrosanct even when the reports are generated any time later as well. So in cases wherein assignments in the source cloud HCM environments have changed post payroll processing, the reports in Fusion Analytics Warehouse will absolutely remain sacrosanct, generated at any point in time as compared to the payroll processing time period. Only in cases wherein in the source cloud HCM environment, the employees' assignments have attributes have been deleted or corrected in a way so that there is no trace left that at the time of payroll processing, the worker was in X department or X assignment attributes. In that case, source doesn't have any such information, so we cannot restore the data in warehouse. Hence, for the second set of use case that I just talked about, we cannot support retrospective reconciliation. Now, let's jump on to the subject area tree and a sample analysis built using the subject area. Before we get into the details of the subject area, there are mainly three aspects of cloud HCM payroll, namely payroll run results, payroll balances, and payroll costing. With the first release of payroll offering under Fusion Analytics Warehouse, we are supporting payroll balances. So the time dimension support with which you can aggregate across any pay period, any time dimension aggregated at yearly, quarterly, month level as well. Hierarchy is mainly the department and org hierarchy, bands, the age band and the tenure band, that is the length of service band. With the support of this band dimension, the analysis that we just talked about, like if as an organization I'm paying higher salary to the new incumbent, that is the lower bracket of the tenure band as compared to the higher bracket of the tenure band, and identify such anomalies. So you can do all such type of analysis using the support for the bands in the subject area. Then you have support for worker dimension, all details related to an employee or a worker in an organization, basic information, personal information, assignment, employment information, diversity, etc. Then you have support for all common dimension like department, business unit, legal employer grade, etc. Under payroll information, you have payroll to which the worker is attached, all related attributes for payroll. You have support for payroll period under which the payment is made. So you can drill down to the lowest grain of pay period as well. Then payroll processes, various payroll processes, legislative data group, payroll statutory unit, tax reporting unit, and worker payroll relationship related details. If you want to drill down to this level as well. Then under payroll balances information, you have balance type. That is, what is the balance name? Could be like overtime, bonus, base pay. These are all different balance names, examples of different balance names. It depends upon how the balances or the elements have been set up in your organization. Then you have balance category, like standard earning, supplemental earning, involuntary, voluntary deduction, etc. Then you have base dimension. So for each balance name or balance type, there could be multiple base dimensions associated. So when you want to analyze a specific balance, it's compulsory to filter, also put a filter on a specific base dimension as well. Otherwise, it will aggregate across all base dimensions associated with that specific balance name. We'll get to that as well in a minute. Then payroll balances details, different assignment related details associated with the payroll balance of a worker. And then comes the measures. So we have support for the base measure like balance value. If you want to do any calculation, you can do all specific filtering and create a custom calculation as well. Then let me first go through this and then we can jump to this second folder. We have support for payroll balances by base category. So like supplemental earning, standard earning and all other different deductions. Then we have all period to date measures, year to date, quarter to date for each of the base category that we saw under this folder, as you can see. Then period ago value for each of the base category that is under this payroll balances by base category, we have period ago value. We'll see a sample in the analysis as well. balance variance. What was the difference? What is the difference between X time pay period and current pay period, or any two time dimension, any 2 year, or likewise? Balance growth rate. How much has it increased or decreased as compared to the past pay period or past time, the other time dimension selected? And now let's come to this one. These are all pre-calculated based on a specific balance category, base category, and base dimension. If at all, anything as per your organization data, which is not available in this out-of-the-box derived measure, and if you still want to calculate the month-to-date or quarter-to-date, year-to-date values, then we have given you this blanket measures as well. You may put a specific filter on a balance name or a base dimension and calculate your own MTD period-to-date or growth rate variance as well. Now let's quickly take a look at the sample analysis and how have we utilized this various measures and dimensions in the subject area in this sample analysis. So as you can see, base pay across all the data that is available, it could be maximum up to 3 years of data. This is the base pay paid, overtime, bonus paid. This analysis, it talks about how much is the earning distribution versus the worker count in specific jobs. So for example, here in the manager job, the worker count is 37. So there are only 37 workers. But if you see, the amount paid is quite high. At the same time, compared to the analyst job, the worker count is much higher as compared to the manager job. It's 64 workers, but the salary amount, earnings, total earnings is much lesser as compared to the manager. So what analysis or what decision, how do I perceive this information is, in my organization, under analyst job, even though there are more workers I have recruited or hired, but the salary amount is substantially less as compared to the workers with manager job, even though, and the worker count with manager job is much lesser. Now let's move to the next one. Under this analysis, what an organization can do is that it's trying to identify how, as an organization, am I paying across various genders. So from this, I can clearly see that the male population in an organization is getting paid substantially higher amount of salary as compared to any other gender in the organization. As you can see, this is the male population payment versus there is a huge gap between the male and female population and the non-binary gender. This tabular formats that you can see for standard earning and supplemental earning, this utilizes all the out-of-the-box measures that we just talked about. In 2019, what is my standard earning? In 2020, how much? In 2021, how much is my standard earning? So in 2021, I can see how much was paid in 2019. How much is the difference between 19 and 20, and what is the growth rate in 20? Since it's positive, that means it shows that 2020 I have paid more than 2019. In 2021, it has decreased. So I can see, okay, the amount is lesser than that of 2020. Similarly, for supplemental earning, similar analysis, similar graphs can be plotted, similar numbers can be plotted. The next one is about period to date accumulation. These are all also available out of the box in the subject area. So in any organization, in any given month or any time period, there can be multiple payments made under payroll. Could be for various reasons like medical expenses, could be bonus, could be any other components. That is one of payments. Now in this specific organization, as you can see, in December month at the start, how much was the standard earning paid? Then over 1 month, various payments were made. So at the end of the month, or let's say if I want to see on 26th of December, how much is the December month standard earning paid? Then I just have to bring in this and that specific time dimension in picture, and I'll be able to identify it. And from the start of the year till 26th of December, how much have I paid? Then I have to pull in the year to date measure and I'll be able to identify it. Similar numbers can also be plotted for supplemental earning, and this can be done for any other deduction components as well. Now, as we were just talking about in the payroll subject area tree, that we have support for payroll balances, and with every balance, there could be multiple base dimensions associated. So if I want to identify for a specific worker under a specific pay period, for a specific balance, what was the value paid, then I have to put a filter on base dimension. Otherwise, as you can see on your screen, for Mr. Brian Joseph, in a specific pay period, if I want to identify regular salary, and if I don't put this base dimension filter, then it will aggregate across all these values, and it will give me aggregate of this total 9-10 rows that you can see. For standard earning, out of the box measure that we have, we already have put a filter of a specific base dimension, so you can just pull the standard earning and identify the value paid to Mr. Brian Joseph in a specific pay period. But for any other calculation, you'll have to put the base dimension. To overcome this thing, with the recent FAW release, what we have done is that we have uptaken the balance group feature in Cloud HCM. So all customers have to do is that they have to set up the balance group with the required base category and base dimension, or a specific balance and base dimension. And when pipeline runs, the pre-built pipeline runs, it will only fetch data according to the setup done by the customers. How will this help organization? First, because balances data is huge, with the support of balance group, it would be substantially reduced. So the pre-built pipeline would run much faster. The time taken would be reduced. And the second thing is, the analysis that you have built using the payroll data, since the underlying data would be reduced, the overall performance of your analysis would be much faster. So you can do multiple analysis, multiple complex reporting on top of that data as well. Details about how to set up the balance group, different combinations across different legislations, base dimension and base category are mentioned under this specific customer connect post, the link of which will be shared at the end of this session. Another feature that we would want to talk about under payroll offering is this payroll metric configuration available in Fusion Analytics Warehouse. So by default, all the derived measures that are available in the subject area will render data only for US legislation. But if in your organization, payroll is processed across various legislation, be it Canada or UK, likewise, or Middle East, then in that case, all you need to do is that set up required balance group in your Cloud HCM, come to this UI, add required legislation in this UI for different payroll metrics that you want to utilize, and then just save this data. And automatically, without any further delay, the subject area tree or the subject area will start rendering data for all the derived measures like the period to date or growth rate and variance based on the setup that exists on this UI. This is all we have today in this session. There was an exclusive webcast that we had conducted for payroll. The link for that is available, and it's available on Customer Connect under events. Payroll blog link. We have written, published a payroll blog with details on balance group and payroll config UI and different use cases that you can do using the payroll subject area, and payroll customer connect post that we just talked about with all the details on what all are different pre-built measures available, how to set up balance group, what are the different base dimension and base category values that exist for different legislation and that you need to select in balance group. So all these details are available under these links.